Good morning, students. I have already uploaded one video on the NTAP for y'all, which is a repetitive video of fractions. Now, based on yesterday's video and today's video, I have formed some questions for y'all and I have solved it for you. Okay, obviously the concept of fractions is very clear to you people till now, but then when many sorts of questions are put together, or if they are asked in some different way, in spite of you knowing the concept, you do get confused. How are we supposed to do it? Concept aapko aata hai, lekin aap confused ho jate ho ki kaise karna hai. So I have put up those questions in a different language, in a different style, and then how we are going to solve it as per the concept that we have learned. Let's see that. Just a moment, children. Just a moment. Just a moment. Okay, so this is a video. This is the screen that is revision fractions chapter. Now, the very first question that I have put up here is, how much is 2 by 5 of 10? Or we can also read it as, how much is 2/5 of 10? Now, the very first thing is, of means x, that means multiply. How much is 2/5 of 10? Now, of means multiply. So we are going to write this particular statement as 2 by 5 into 10. We are going to write it as 2 by 5 into 10. Now, the next step you already know in this particular case is, if you all remember, what do we do? What do we do, children? Yes, ask yourself. I actually divide the whole number by the denominator. I actually divide the whole number by the denominator. And then whatever answer I get, I multiply it by the numerator. So here, who is your whole number? Here, who is your whole number? My whole number is 10. And who is your denominator? My denominator is 5. So 10 divided by 5, give me the answer as 2. The answer is 2, and now this 2 is multiplied by the numerator. Who is my numerator? My numerator is 2. Who is my numerator? My numerator is 2. So here I got the answer as 2. This 2 will be multiplied by your numerator. That is 2, which is equals to 4. So that means 2/5 of 10. 2/5 fraction of 10 is 4. 2/2 kitna hoga? 5. Right? So 2/5 of 10 is 4. Now I hope you all remember this. Then the next question is, two or more fractions named same amount are called dash fractions. Two or more fractions named same amount are called as dash fractions. Now, children, you already know what are equivalent fractions. any fraction taken, multiply both the numerator and denominator by the same number, you get an equivalent fraction. Any fraction taken, divide it by the same number, the numerator and denominator, you get an equivalent fraction. मतलब चाहे आप डिवाइड करें चाहे आप मल्टीप्लाई करें आपको सेम ही फ्रैक्शन मिलता है. बट जब क्वेश्चन इस फॉर्म में पूछा जाए टू और मोर फ्रैक्शंस नेम सेम अमाउंट आर कॉल्ड एज इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शंस. प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस चिल्ड्रन वेल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. फ्रैक्शन विच हैज वन एज न्यूमरेटर. Fraction which has 1 as numerator, obviously it is called as unit fraction. This is nothing new to you. Now, simplest form of 16 by 36 is. Simplest form of 16 by 36 is. 16. अगर आपको tables अच्छे से आते हैं तो आपको 5 seconds लगेंगे. Just to know that the 4 is the highest common factor or 4 is the biggest common factor between 16 and 36. So you need to divide 16 and 36 by 4. Otherwise, physically sit and find out the factors of 16 and 36 and you'll come to know 4 is common between 2 and it is largest also. And then divide it by 16 and divide 16 and 36 by 4. So I get the answer 4 by 9. Now this 4 by 9 is the simplest form of 1636. Now the next question is mixed fraction or mixed number of 13 by 4. Just a minute, children. Mixed number of 13 by 4. What you have to do? You have to actually divide 13 by 4. The physical division has to take place. Now, when I do this, I see I get the quotient to be 3. There is a remainder left as 1. And there is denominator or the divisor, they both are equal, which is equals to 4. The denominator and the divisor, they both are equal and it is same as 4. And then I have to write it in a form of QRD. In which form I have to write? I have to write it in form of QRD. What is my Q? It is 3. What is my R? It is 1. And what is my D? It is 4. So the mixed fraction of 13 by 4 or mixed numeral, mixed number of 13 by 4 is 3 1/4. See children, I'm repeating the words so that if in the question paper they asked you mixed number or if they asked you mixed fraction or if they asked you mixed numeral, they all mean the same and the steps, the concept remain the same. QRD. I need Q, I need R, and D is always there with me in form of denominator. Let's look at the next question. How many fifths are there in 6 1/5? Now, this is a wonderful question, children, and it is not something that you don't know, but the moment they put it in different words and they jumble up, they confuse you. You are not supposed to get confused. How many fifths are there in 6 1/5? Or how many fifths are there in 6 1/5? First step, convert your mixed fraction, that is 6 1/5, into a mixed into an improper fraction. Now, what do it in improper fraction? You use the MAD method. That is, multiply, add, denominator. multiply add denominator. 5 into 6 plus 1. 5 into 6 plus 1 is equals to 31, and retain your denominator, 31 by 5. Now children, here there are 31 fifths in 6, 1 by 5. Children, what does this mean actually? If you look here at the graphical representation, आपके पास 6 rectangular boxes हैं. हर box जो है वो 5 parts में divided है. तो यानी उसका हर part जो होगा वो क्या कहलाएगा? 1 by 5. ऐसे कितने 1 by 5 हैं? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. And 31. कितने 1 by 5 हैं? कितने 1 by 5 है 6 boxes में? 31. Actually तो 36 है, लेकिन मैंने सिर्फ 6 1 by 5 लिए हैं. तो इसीलिए मैंने actually 31 1 by 5 pieces pick किए हैं. ये हर एक सिंगल बॉक्स को 1 by 5 बोलते हैं. ऐसे मैंने 31 पिक किए हैं, यूनिट फ्रैक्शंस. आई पिक्ड अप 1 by 5, ऐसे 31 पिक किए हैं फ्रॉम अवेलेबल 7 रेक्टेंगुलर बॉक्सेस. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी सी दैट देयर आर 31. There are 31 6 1 5th, 31 1 5th in 6 1 by 5. There are 31 1 5th in 6 1 by 5. So I hope children, you all have understood. These are just different ways of asking the questions. Don't get confused. You know everything. It's just put up in a different manner. And please watch it regularly so that you all get clear with your doubts. And of course, during the live session also, we will be doing. In tomorrow's live session, I will be doing data handling, the last part, that is the pie chart questions we will do. I hope you all have watched my video on that. And we are going to do the exercise and the revision. So children, have a good day. Please be ready with your doubts, and so that we can move on fast and more with our revision. Thank you, children. Have a good day.